has been amazing. And I just can't believe it. I'm beside myself. I'm so happy that people seem to be enjoying what they see and what they hear, and that they want to see and hear more. And we're just looking forward to putting together more. And Cottonmouth, what'd you say?
Yeah, ask Cottonmouth. So what do you see for the, I'm a two-part question. What do you consider the status of local artists in town right now in terms of getting recognition they deserve, and what's next?
In terms of what's going on right now in Dallas, I love it. Yeah. I mean, you know, I just wish that everybody in the city, and I'm saying like people that download records, yeah, people that buy music, people that go to the shows, people that know the business, and those who are just fans and don't care who made the beat or who the artist is, just once you find they from Dallas, like jump on it. You know, but it's not like the music. We got Youngs that's here. We got the Triple D Hats that's here. We got great athletes. We got high schools winning championships every year. We got more things going on associated with hip hop besides the music.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what I love about this film. It's not like my homeboy got killed because he was selling drugs on in South Dallas type of film, you know. And I was just telling this cat, I've been knowing him since Rick Ricardo days. Like, I'm watching the Vanilla Ice thing, and I'm like, he know, I'm young at the Vanilla Ice video shoot.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the background, you know. I wrote on Vanilla Ice album, you know. Chic Fu, Goldfinger. I wrote for Nemesis, you know, but I was a kid.
I was a record boy.
You know. So it's just like being here right now. Like for us to be in this room right here, visualizing this film and watching this film, is like history.
Yeah.
You know, but I'm more proud that nobody got killed.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, the average hip hop movie, somebody got killed. You know, he messed with his girlfriend, got killed. You know, every hip hop movie. So it's so authentic, and you can present this worldwide. It's gonna be respected because it's just not about the music. Like Curly, I used to go pick Curly up when I was 16, 17 years old. We had Issues Productions in West Dallas.
Yeah.
We take him to Corsicana.
Yeah.
Real story. I'm 15, am I lying, Curly? We had speakers. I was a young cat.
Show him in the back of the car.
We go get Curly, he DJ for us. We made money off the dough. Curly beer now sweating, and we getting it on in Corsicana.
Yeah.
A lot of things in the film wasn't talked about, how DOC used to battle snake them.
Yep.
It's the old clip. Man, shoot that motherfucker shit. am I lying, Curly? So the MC battles was the only thing that's left out in this film.
Yeah.
Like, West Dallas and Old Cliff didn't get along in hip hop in Dallas back then.
Yeah.
For real.
So, but I said that during the film, it's just not in there yet, right then?
Yeah.
Yeah, so. We left a lot of things out, but it's all good. Like we see Mr. Pookie, and we don't see Big Chief. And Big Chief and Mr. Pookie and Lucha had beef, rap beef for years. Cause Big Chief started out with us in Stony Crew.
Yeah,
so you talking to the history man down here, so you know, it might be a film about Cottonmouth telling y'all about Dallas just a bit. There's a lot of things left out, but I love the film, and I know what's for the future. We got The Road, we got Young Nation, we got T-Cash, we got a gang of artists that's making a lot of noise.
Yeah.
And we had eras of people like the Big Tux and the DRD, I'm saying Dirty South Riders, Tom Tom, everybody that they had their little stages of shine in Dallas.
Yeah.
But the main thing is trying to get the radio to understand that this city, we support everybody.
Yeah.
But nobody supports us.
Yep.
And that's Cottonmouth's biggest problem for years. They see me coming out, I'm grown, and they like, okay, he a man now. But when I was young, here come Cottonmouth. You know. But like I said, when I was young, we opened up for these guys. I used to sit back in the back and watch this guy dance his heart out. It was us, then them, then MC Hammer.
And I want to say this. I mean, y'all are so influential and have an influence beyond what people know.
Yeah.
Like, as we sit here and, like, you see Jabbar out there, many of y'all don't know. other than Tyrone, Jaborn is one of the only people whose name Erica Badu calls out on a record.
Right? Yeah.
Jaborn is smooth. And when Erica went to, and you saw, and Monopoo was on there.
Yeah.
You know, when Erica